Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. In the first video of this tutorial series, we talked about the most important piece of equipment in a robotic system, the robot arm. If you didn't see this video, go check it out before listening to this one. Today's topic is almost as vital as the first one. Robotic arms are pretty cool, but they are not very useful without a second piece of equipment. What can you do with a robot arm without a tool attached to it? The answer is not much. Robot tools comes in a wide variety of model depending on the system application. It can be a gripper used to handle objects, a welding gun to join pieces together, a glue dispenser, a paint gun, etc., etc. RoboDK is able to handle all kinds of applications. Today, we will learn to use standard and customized tools in RoboDK. Let's see how we can do that. In the basic guide series, I showed you how to create a custom tool using a CAD model. But that's pretty much it. I didn't go further than that. There's a bunch of things that were left on the side, and we will address those today. This topic, like the robotic topic, was a bit too long to put in one single video. So, this time again, today's topic will be split in two parts. Make sure to watch the second one later on. In the current station, I have only the robot, an ABB IRB120, same one as I used in the last video. At the moment, there is no tool attached to the flange. Like I said, in the basic guide, I showed you how to create a custom tool. But let's say that we are simply doing some random tests and that we don't really need a specific tool. Just a generic one would do the trick. Instead of designing, importing, and setting up the tool manually, let's open the online library. Again, in the basic guide, I only showed you that you can download robots from the library. But there is actually more than that. Click on the type filter. We already talked about the first few ones, the robots, 5, 6, and 7 degrees of freedom, the delta robots, external axis, object, and later on, tool. In this situation, we can use one of the tools available here. We have some welding guns, grippers, pencil, paint gun, 3D printing extruder, some machining spindle, a few robotic grippers, and a calibration tool. Let's select the pencil for this example. Download. The pen is now on the robot flange. It's a pretty quick way to add a tool to your station. We could do the same, let's say, with the robotic gripper, or with the welding gun. Okay, let's use this tool for this section of the tutorial. Double click the tool. You can also double click the name in the station tree. Now we have the tool details panel, and at the top, the name weld gun. Just below the visibility options for the tool itself, or just for the TCP. Okay, to explain you the next section, it will be better if I use the view extended option. Okay, I want to see the robot from the side and I want to zoom on the tool. Nice. Okay, before going further, we need to define an abbreviation I will use pretty often. TCP, or tool center point. It represents the position of the tool where the action should take place. In the example we have here, it represents the tip of the welding rod coming out of the welding gun. It could also represent the center point of a gripper, the focal point of an inspection tool, or the tip of a drill bit mounted on a spindle. The TCP will help you precisely grab parts, control the orientation of the tool along a path, or simply manipulate the robot around. By just pressing Alt and using the TCP frame, I can reorient the tool around its y-axis. The easiest way to define the position of your TCP is to have your tool dimensions in hand. If you have those, you can go in the tool panel. We have here tool center point, so this coordinate system here, with respect to our robot flange, so this coordinate system here. You can just come here and enter the values manually using your CAD drawing dimensions. In this case, to go from the robot flange to the actual TCP, we need to move along the Z-axis, about 371 millimeters, and a bit backward along the X-axis, about minus 4 millimeters. Like I said, here the TCP is not touching the welding gun, because in reality, the welding rod would come out of the gun. The translation along the Y-axis is zero, because if we change view, front-facing view, the welding gun is aligned with the robot flange. So that's it for the XYZ coordinates. Now we need to manage the angle. The rotation go in this order. Rotation around Z, rotation around Y, and rotation around X. By convention, we almost always try to set up our TCP orientation in a way that the Z-axis is coming out of the tool. In this case, to do so, we need to rotate 45 degrees around the Y-axis. Clockwise is a negative rotation, and counterclockwise is a positive rotation. Here, we are rotating counterclockwise, so plus 45 degrees. Okay, let's continue with our tool panel. The only thing left for the moment is the More Options button. This reveals four buttons: Apply Scale, Change Colors, Edit Events, and Apply Move. Apply Scale is a quick and dirty way of resizing the tool. Here, considering that I got this from the library, I was not able to choose its size or the position of the TCP. If I zoom out a bit, we can see that it's a bit big of a tool for the size of the robot. Let's reduce it to 80% of its original size. So 0.8. Nice. As you can see, the 80% ratio was also applied to the TCP position. Therefore, no need to adjust it. The change color button speaks for itself. I will talk more about the colors in a future video talking explicitly about objects. But for the moment, let's say that we just want to change the blue section of the welding gun for another color. Click on the blue square and select the color you want. Let's go for this kind of pink. Here we go. The color was changed. The next option is the Edit Events one. I won't talk about this in this video. This requires some knowledge about macros and about our API. I do believe that those subjects need a proper introduction before using them. So the last button is the Apply Move. This option is directly linked to the Move Geometry section just below. So let's tackle them both at the same time. This section is kind of a lifesaver if the objects you are using as a tool was not properly designed. In this case, it was properly designed, so no need to use it. But if I jump in this other station and I'm having a situation like this one, the tool was imported, it's fixed to the robot flange, but not at the right spot. The cause of this problem is quite simple. The 3D model was designed with this point as the origin, instead of using the center of the cylindrical part. Obviously, my first recommendation would be to design your tool with this point in mind, but the situation here can also be fixed through RoboDK. Simply use the Move Geometry text boxes to move the 3D model and place it where it's supposed to be on the flange. Just like that. Then, press Apply Move, to apply the modification you want. This completes the explanation for the tool details panel, and it's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope it was helpful, and if you think so, please hit that thumbs up button. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you can come back and look for the newest tutorials. The second part of this tutorial video will be released shortly. Have a good day, guys.